Hey there, Capricorn. Welcome. Am I recording? Yes, I'm recording. Good news. Welcome to your reading for the week of August 2nd. I don't know what is going on here. I don't know. Hopefully this is recording. For some reason, my recorder is red. Whatever. We'll figure it out, Capricorn, but thank you for being here. Really appreciate it. We're going to just jump right in here and see what's going on for you. We're going to take a look at your current general energies in this first row. We're going to take a look at anything unexpected that could be coming in for you in your second row. And then we're going to look at any messages from your guides in your last row. And also at the end, I am going to pull three yes or no question cards, and I will give you time to think of those questions. Also, if you don't have questions, that's fine too. I'm going to just put them all together and answer them as just one kind of like personal-ish reading. But let's see here, Capricorn. What we have going on for you at this time. And Capricorn, you start off with this Eight of Swords here. So I feel for some of you, definitely like looking or needing to set yourself free from something. Three of Swords, Five of Swords, Page of Wands. Page of Wands is like needing to go on an adventure. Sometimes, not always, but sometimes I look at the Page of Wands as almost like having a match and having a match book, but needing to strike the match. It's like you need to get started, right? So I do feel that it's like there's never, you know, as I always say, there's never a perfect moment to do anything. The perfect moment is right now, right? Or yesterday, which is impossible. And unless they invent, you know, time travel sometime soon, which I don't know, who knows? Maybe the aliens land next, right? And they bring us time travel, totally possible. But what I would say here is that I feel like it's time for you to get started on something here, Capricorn. And we're going to figure out what that is. Now, you have the Three of Swords, Five of Swords, Page of Wands. Again, needing to get moving. Three of Swords, I do get like this one thing after another type of vibe for you off the Three of Swords, meaning like if you've been trying to start a business or a new project, it's like one thing after another. I feel as far as love is concerned as well, it's like big picture reading. Here, I would say this is your whole entire life. And again, even in love, I feel like maybe you've tried to get into relationships, but things kind of seem to always go the same way. I think things are, it's just like one, you know, similar experience after another. That can drive you crazy. I feel like it can make you feel like you're on the hamster wheel, right? Just like you're just running in place and not really making any progress. And I feel like you've been experiencing that energy for quite a long time here, Capricorn. The good news is, I feel like you're entering into this almost like blank space is kind of what I get over here. Like, and that's like the message from your guides here. Very exciting. And again, we're going to clarify this and get deeper into it. But really, the energy I'm getting is more of like this blank canvas where it's like you're a little bit more, still not perfect, right? A blank canvas is not perfect because where the hell do you start in the first place, right? That's always the challenge for artists, right? They're like, how the hell do I start? And so I feel like that's definitely still a challenge. But at least I feel like you have kind of freedom. Or you will be gaining a lot of freedom here. I do feel like some of you have gone through a breakup or have maybe recently experienced a breakup, but again, it's just like a similar experience. Let's see where this is going right away here, Capricorn. Three of Cups, could be a celebration coming in for you in the future. You have the Ten of Cups, love it. And the, are you kidding me? And the Empress, total abundance. This is what you have to look forward to here, Capricorn. And I almost feel like this is like a treasure chest. You know, it's like what you have to look forward to in the future is a treasure chest full of whatever it is you want. Do you want love and a family? Boom, right here, Ten of Cups. Fortune after difficulty, right here, Ten of Cups. So I feel there's a lot of happiness and good things that are available to you. As I always say, these things are not going to magically appear in your life. Yes, you have to do the work, but if you do it, this is what you're going to get right here. Definitely a lot of abundance that is available to you as well. So I do get like a very happy vibe here. So I feel like this blank space that you're entering into where you kind of are going to be free to, you know, maybe create your own reality. And look, it's looking very good here, Capricorn. Next in the area of the unexpected, you have the Ant Spirit. This says time to collaborate. For a lot of you, I do feel like you could be collaborating with people here. Obviously, that's what this card says. I think it's going to make things lighter, right? It's like ants can pick up very heavy things compared to their body size. And I feel like someone could be carrying a lot of weight for you or helping you. This could be in any area of your life, actually. For some of you, I'm getting children. And what I mean by that is I feel like there could be someone coming in, if you have children, there could be someone coming into your life to help you, which that would be nice. For others, I feel like this is like in work or business, you could be collaborating where maybe in the past you would never collaborate. I have a lot of Capricorn in my chart as well, and I prefer to work alone myself. Capricorn, I do feel like that could be a Capricorn energy. Like I said, I have a ton of Capricorn in my chart. I might as well be a Capricorn at this point. And what I would say here is I totally get it. I totally get not wanting to work with other people, but I feel like you're starting to see the benefits, or you will be, and that could be very unexpected. Could also be love as well. If you're looking for love, I feel like what's unexpected is you could be meeting someone who actually does the work, who actually carries their own weight here, Capricorn. You have the Four of Pentacles, Hangman, and the Devil. I feel for a lot of you that this is some sort of change. Four of Pentacles is always the same, right? It's like, this is where I was getting that kind of like hamster wheel type of energy. It's like feeling like there's no escape, feeling like you're just moving too fast. Hangman says you have gained a new perspective. Something has changed. It's a card of enlightenment. And guess what? You have the enlightenment card right here. So it's like clearly you have like either woken up to something or you have become enlightened by some opportunity. And here you are, Devil. So I feel that this is just you showing up in a very strong position here. I really feel that in a lot of ways, the Devil can represent like an energy vampire. You know, it can represent something that steals your energy away. And, you know, right here is the black box of Saturn right here on the Devil. And the black box of Saturn on the Devil card, it can represent something where light just disappears into it. Not always true, but that's what I'm feeling right now. I feel like something has been kind of sucking your energy away for a very long period of time. Could be work, business, love, whatever. And it's like, I feel that is the change that is happening here. But let's see where this goes for you, Capricorn. You have the Nine of Cups, wishes, wish fulfillment coming in for you here. You have the Seven of Wands. You're going to have to set boundaries. And the Magician, it's like you are definitely, remember what I said about blank canvas. Magician is you creating your own reality, which I already knew that was, you know, what's going on here with the Knight of Cups. I'll explain that in a minute, but I feel you are really creating your own reality at this time. I do feel like a very strong need to set boundaries, especially if you're entering into a co-creative experience with a person, you know, especially in work or business. I get this weird feeling here where it's like if you're working with another person, I do get this energy more of control, right? Where it's like you could be working with a person. I feel as long as you're very clear upfront with your expectations, right? If you're like hiring someone, if you're working together with a person, if you're building a relationship with a person, I feel like as long as you are clear upfront, then things will be fine. But I would make sure to be clear upfront. You know, I would make sure to be very, very, you know, kind of like open, honest. And I feel like there's a need for you to make sure that you're not giving too much as well, is what I'm getting. Mostly in work or business, I just get the sense like of maybe you have a business and like someone comes in, I feel like they would be a great addition to your business, but I feel like they could get like very carried away, you know? And it's like, if you're not clear upfront about what you want, I feel like they're just gonna, you know, get lost in the woods. So, you know, make sure that doesn't happen here with this energy. Looking really good, Capricorn, I like this. Next, in the area of messages from your guides, you have the Enlightenment card. I feel like you have been enlightened, like I said, with the Hangman. I feel like you have gained a new understanding. And this new understanding is like how you're going to escape the hamster wheel, basically. You have the Queen of Cups, the Tower, the Queen of Wands, and the Knight of Cups. I get this major blank canvas here, where, like I was saying here, it's like a blank space or a blank slate is what I was going for. The Tower is like total destruction, but it's like we need to rebuild the Tower. I feel like the Tower has already happened for you here, Capricorn, and it's like time for you to rebuild it how you want. The Queen of Wands is wholehearted energy. She, you know, to be successful with the Queen of Wands, you have to be bold, assertive, and you have to put your heart and soul into something. And the Knight of Cups is a card of imagination. He is normally looking into that cup. He is imagining what he wants to manifest. He is imagining what he wants to create in his life. So I feel for a lot of you, this is like saying, if you can dream it, you can have it. Plain and simple. Queen of Cups is about like nurturing something. We kind of get that actually with both these cards here. the Queen of Wands and the Queen of Cups. So if you're like trying to create something like a business or a job or something like that, I would like use your powers of manifestation to get something moving here. But definitely a lot of success, I feel, kind of coming in for you here with this reading, Capricorn. I would make sure to stay focused. I do feel a surprise over here as well. I do feel like the universe could be surprising you with love as well. And it's kind of like a shocking surprise with the Tower. So I do feel like for some of you, it's like a person will be approaching you with that Knight of Cups energy. And that could be very surprising. Definitely could be a water sign as well if you're looking for love. Let's see here, Capricorn, where this is going. Wheel of Fortune, damn, Capricorn, your destiny. Wheel of Fortune is a change in your fortunes, happiness. This is you making, this is like a major wish, getting the Nine of Cups with the Wheel of Fortune. I also feel like it's saying, again, that entering into this co-creative experience will be very beneficial. So if you're working on a team with other people, if you're building a business, I keep preaching this stuff right now because I just see it in the astrology. To me, between now, 2025, very significant time for like the rest of our lives. Like the what we do now, between now and the end of 2025, is going to kind of determine the rest of our lives. So I would, you know, try to work with other people. The universe, the reason I preach this as well, I'm like, trust me, like I said, I am not a co-creative person. I'd rather be alone. I'd rather be like a hermit living on in my little Pisces cave, right? So I totally understand. But what I would say is that really, it's like looking at the astrology, if we work together with other people, if we build abundance with other people, we're just going to be like 20 times more successful in love and business and work and health, everything. So, you know, it's not just about money. It's about everything in your life. And so it's like we're creating a lot of abundance. And that's what I would do if I were you. You have the Eight of Wands, quick success, quick changes coming in for you. I feel like this could be, shocking, sudden communication from a person who finds you attractive. I don't think you're going to be like, oh my God, I'm so shocked. I feel like you're just going to be like, oh wow, I'm surprised that this person is interested in me. For some of you, it's kind of weird. I kind of get like one of those, it could be one of those moments where you get like a message from someone from high school. That's like the feeling I get, the story that's popping into my head. Is that some of you could be like getting a message from someone who's like, oh, I was always into you in high school. And I feel like you were like always into them in high school. It's like, have you ever had one of those moments, Capricorn? It's like you could be having a communication with a person. Maybe that's not exactly what happens, but I feel like it's like similar to that. Maybe you just worked with the person. Maybe they're like, I was always into you, or like you were into me. It's like that type of surprise that I get here. And this could lead to love. So love it. And you have the Temperance card as well. Temperance is, says you need to like do the work, right? The Knight of Cups, he's normally looking into that cup. He is scrying. He is seeing what his future life could be. But he's not crossing this river that's on this card here, Capricorn. Temperance is saying that something is going to require some back and forth, energy, basically. It's like saying, maybe you're like, oh, I want to be, I want to be an astronaut, but maybe you're too old to be an astronaut. Maybe there's no way in hell that you would actually fly into outer space. The Temperance card is like saying, okay, yeah, it's like you have this dream, you want to be an astronaut, that it's like really would be very difficult for you to do maybe, but the Temperance card says there are still things you could do. You could start a YouTube channel where you talk about outer space. You could start a YouTube channel where you pretend to be an astronaut. Maybe you want to be a dinosaur. Again, you could dress up as a dinosaur and start a YouTube channel where you are a dinosaur. So Knight of Cups is about like starting from a place where there's like a dream you have. Maybe you know that you can't have the exact dream. Temperance says, yeah, you can't have the exact thing that you want, but if you work it a little bit, if you put in a little bit of effort, you might be able to manifest something that's pretty damn close, or that allows you to at least interact with, an energy that you want. And you never know. You know what might happen is, again, when the aliens land, don't say I didn't warn you, right? When the aliens land, it's like maybe they're like, hey, anybody who wants to come into outer space, come on, get on the ship, right? There you go. Now you're an astronaut, Capricorn. So boom. But Capricorn, amazing. Love it. So let's see where this is going. I'm going to pull three yes or no question cards here, Capricorn. We're going to do one, two, and three. Three. Feel free to pause this video if you need time to think your questions. One, two, three. Right here. But for question number one, I would say yes, King of Pentacles. So yes, I just feel like saying yes. For question number two, I would say yes. I feel like you already know the answer to question number two. So actually, I would say yes or no. I feel like whatever you think the answer is, then there you go. For question number three, I would say yes, the world. So I really feel three yeses for you. Putting it all together here, Capricorn, I feel like you're building more long-term security. And again, the world makes perfect sense with the whole hamster wheel thing. It's like you're finally escaping from this race, you know, from this like spinning energy. The world is a card of going through a transformation. So definitely very good energy for you. But I love this reading for you, Capricorn. So thank you for being here. Really appreciate it. Make sure to watch your sun, moon, and rising for a full picture of what's going on for you at this time. Also, feel free to like and subscribe. But thank you, Capricorn, and definitely enjoy your week.